Hey folks, thanks for stopping by. This week I'm going to be making a measuring spoon set from four pieces of spalted, dyed, stabilized sycamore. Stick around, we'll get started. Okay, since the length of this tube is approaching the quill travel of my drill press, I figured I'd go ahead and drill them out here rather than on the drill press. So it needs a seven millimeter hole. So let me grab a drill chuck with a 7 millimeter bit and we'll get these drilled out. Okay, let me glue the tubes in and trim them down to size and get them mounted on a, one of them mounted on a pen mandrel, and I'll be back. Later. Okay, got mounted on a pen mandrel on my headstock, the mandrel saber on my tailstock. I've got some 7 millimeter bushings on either side of it. It's not 7 millimeters for the parts. I didn't purchase the bushings for the kit because I figured I could just, you know, take a pair of calipers and get down to the right size. But at this point, I do need to determine what I'm going to do as far as shape. Let me get the kits, the pieces of the kit, and I'll show you kind of what the style of it is. Got a front piece and a back piece, and there's a little bead there and a little bead there, so I could just dome it slightly to make a shape to it, or I could make it kind of club shaped, kind of rounded over to the end as it goes down to fit onto it. And I think that may be what I end up doing, kind of make a kind of a club shape. We grab a small spindle gouge and I'll start working on that. And I've got a set of calipers set to just under these diameters. So let me go ahead and do the other four, and I'll get back to you, and we'll go to the desk and put them together.
3 hours later.
Okay, assembly is pretty, should be pretty straightforward. The first thing I'm going to do is put all of the finials into the back end of the kit and press them on, or the back end of the barrel. Tip nut onto one of the spoons so that I can align it so that the holes in the top are all the same. So I'm going to do it so that it's like that to the side, and then screw the spoon out and press the tip nut in. That way, it's screwed together. Okay. So with that done, it's just a matter of installing the small rings and then installing all of the spoons onto the large ring. Thanks for sticking with me, since it seems like you made it this far. I try to put out one about every week or so, so if you want to see the next one, go ahead and hit subscribe. This is a new project for me, so tell me what you think. Do you like it? It sucks? Drop me a comment. If you like it, feel free to give me a thumbs up. Otherwise, I'll see you next week. Take care.